Mr. Bluebird's on my shoulder. It's the truth.
Hey, to the viewers who have been on this channel for a while, y'all remember when, like, 3 years ago, when I was like, I'm gonna do a Learn to Shred a Sled series. Remember how far that got? We got, like, 3 episodes? Yeah. That's okay. It's 2022, by the way. It's literally 3 years after I started that. Oh, but it is beautiful up here. The snow's not very good today, so I'm gonna briefly do an intro and then I'll finish this video this weekend, I hope. There's one item that I carry with me on a sled, and it's an enamel metal mug, and I'll show you why. What did you say?
My sled is 95 degrees. It's colder than my mug.
Like I was saying, and I know I have like awesome scars under my eyes. I don't even hear about it. One of the things that I bring every time we go sledding is right in here. Oh, maybe I'll get it out before I record this. Okay, I have the thing that I wanted to show. So, when you first see this, you won't really understand what the heck you're looking at. There, can y'all see it? It's kind of weird, huh? What is it? Oh! it's a survival mug. And the idea here is, this is actually a great thing to have in the backcountry or anywhere you're camping and survival, because it's a little low profile cookware thing. You can melt snow into metal. You can't melt snow into the plastic water bottles that we always bring. So I always have this just in case we're spending the night and we need some water. I always have a garbage bag. Actually, is there two in here? There might be two garbage bags in here. Big like contractor garbage bags, because nothing, I mean, these are just as waterproof as like a poncho. So that's just a little water barrier. I've actually slept in the woods a couple nights with this, or with something just like this. So I always bring that. I always have hand warmers, especially old ones currently. I don't know if these would even work. These feel pretty old. I might need to change them out. I always have I don't even know if this company is still around. Is Pro Bar still a thing? This thing is old. Anyway, the point is I always have some sort of protein, yes. I have a little medical kit in here. This is really small. Nothing really substantial in here. I have another one that I always bring too, but this is just kind of a little backup. I have fire starters. These are actually Brian Card and I. He has the channel Bri Freedom. He and I made these. These are, if you take just like cotton balls and you use Vaseline or cover them in Vaseline, these will actually be a nice little fire starter. And then this is just an old drill bit case, or a tube that a drill bit came in. So I have that. It's a little fire starter. I have these. These are these like snap glow sticks. They're super cheap. What is all the black crap on this one? I don't know. Anyway. These ones I get on Amazon in like a 50-piece pack, and these things actually stay lit a long amount of time. And the idea behind these is, or compared to just, I mean, obviously this is all supplemental. I bring other stuff. This isn't the only thing I bring, or this isn't the only like equipment I bring. That would be hilarious. But these are supplemental. I don't know. You might need them if your batteries all die. These are actually pretty bulletproof if your batteries do die. I have this, an old like flower firecracker or firework. And I don't know why I have this. I think Oh, actually, I do know why I have this. And I am not really going to use this, but if you didn't have a hand flare, a road flare like I carry when we go into the backcountry, if it's night and you need a extraction from a helicopter, what better way to show someone from the air that you're there than by lighting off a little flare, not flare, a little flower firecracker. On the snow, of course, I'm not going to start a forest fire. I would never do that. I would always use that in a snowy field because that's where the helicopter could see you anyway. And then it's all covered with a nice old sock, which, I don't know, if you're really desperate, I'm sure there's a use for. So yeah, that always stays right here. Now that I showed you guys that piece of junk thing, I feel obliged to make sure you know that that's not the only thing I carry. So here, let's see. So looking at my pack, zippers are tough with one hand. I have a Leatherman tool with a flashlight in here and some not expired energy chews. And that one. And this one, I always have, let's see, this is a more in-depth first aid kit. I'm gonna pull it out, you guys can see it right there. Trauma pack. That's like quick clot emergency, stop bleeding. I also carry a backpack that I can't find the zippers on ever.
Have I given you?
Does anyone? Let's see. I also carry a SAM splint, an ace bandage. This is the hood of my climb lock saw. I don't like riding with the hood on with a helmet, but if you're out camping the night or in a survival situation, that hood probably gonna keep warm. Like I said, ace bandage, paracord, and this little guy. Thanks for that, Covey, by the way. I think, Covey, you bought that for me, I think, if you're watching this, which I don't know why you would. And then on my sled, I have a different toolkit that I carry along with a spare belt, etc., like everyone should. In here I have more hand warmers, I have a lighter, I have another mini flashlight, and then I also have this guy, which I don't know, I feel, and this thing's pretty lightweight. I probably should go through and get a bit obsessive about weighing all this stuff, but ain't nobody got time for that. Anyway, over here on the sled, like I said, that thing stays in here. In here I have a spare pair of gloves. These are made by Flylo, which I believe is a company based out of Jackson Hole. I'm not sure. These things are awesome though. These were $40. They're actually quite warm for what they are. Very waterproof for what they are as well. And they're good, like work gloves, gloves that you don't care about. This is a tool kit that has way too much crap in it. Spare belt, siphon hose. The only other thing that I put on the sled, and I need to go through, I want to get like a tunnel bag actually so I can take some of the weight out of the backpack because I also carry my shovel and probe there. I have a cooker on this side of the sled, and then this little goggle warmer, which absolutely sucks. You can't fit anything in there. Any goggles anyway, you can fit other stuff. And what snowmobile wouldn't be complete with duct tape all over the bodywork? Anyway, so that's just I decided I'd make a fun little video. Hopefully it was entertaining. It probably wasn't too useful, but yeah. It's for fun. All right, thanks for watching. Like I said, I'll get some better videos coming your guys' way. But I don't have Adobe on my computer yet. I'm still working on it. I have the old, like, the 2012 release. Or not 2012. Adobe Premiere Elements 12. Because it was the last Premiere program they made, or they sold, that didn't require a subscription. Which is ridiculous. I don't want to subscribe to get a program. I want to just pay for the program once and not pay $60 a month or whatever the bull crap is. Anyway, you guys are in a box. Whoa, that's weird. What's going on in there?
Oh, it's just a book.
Okay. All right. Thanks for watching. See you guys soon.
Where's my mom? Look at those perfect lines. Oh, that looks epic. Sometimes they do stagger when they're, if there's any possibility for avalanche. It's just best practice. There's Dad. That is cute. Man, that was awesome.
What do you think, sweetheart?
I want to make a little of that.
It looks a little bushy. Wow. You guys are so cool. Ooh, that's awesome.
You guys made a fancy little design as you came down. I could see your little design, your little...
It looked so good.